Was this film a bit of a nightmare to edit?
Good question. It was incredibly difficult to edit in the sense that the moment you made, like, okay, a normal movie, you know, you can say, okay, let's try this, let's try that, and then press play and watch it. With this, you go through and make a few changes. You can't press play and just watch it, because if you've taken any time out or changed anything to your timing, you have to basically refit all the orchestrations before you can watch it. And up until fairly late in the process, we were working with program music, so the music would have to be reprogrammed to fit any cuts we'd done. So sometimes, you know, like, just to screen it once for myself would be like a 3 or 4 day Herculean effort after the point at which I said, let's watch this cut. So that was very unusual compared to most movies. I also think there's a particular, because people are singing a melody, you can obviously only cut to them at, you can cut to a shot if they're singing that particular thing in that particular moment. And so anything with choruses, let's say at the end of the day you had lots of characters in the tunnel. If I was shooting cutaways, unless the cutaway runs for the entire song, you can only cut them for the moment the camera's on them. And if you don't, you want the shot there, you can't use it anywhere else. It's very hard to move stuff around. It's a particular discipline, cutting a musical.
And with the length of both the stage musical and your film, was there ever a consideration that there might be an interval of any kind?
There was, actually. Particularly when my first assembly ran at 4 hours, you know, it might have even needed a day off for an interval.
Come back tomorrow.
Two movies. At a certain point, I thought I became rather kind of curious about the power of it if you could just experience it in one unbroken whole. But it was very tough to cut down because, going back to your editing question, I've never made something before where there are basically scenes that you can't cut in any scenario because they're globally iconic, like Dream to Dream, Empty Chairs, On My Own, Stars. And so you sat in the editing room knowing you were having to navigate and therefore protect certain things. Whereas, like on the King's Speech was based on an unproduced play, and it was a story that wasn't even in it hadn't even made it into the history books. I could cut what I liked and no one would know. In fact, I did cut a major thing that no one does know that I cut. Thank goodness I did. So part of the directorial challenge and the editing challenge is to make these moments utterly essential to the film and pivotal to the film, because you know whatever happens, they have to be there.
This is a slightly more flippant question, but which song of the Les Mis canon do you get stuck in your head the most?
I think at the end of the day, and Stars, weirdly.
Although one of the harder ones to sing, but
I sing it.
Just in your head. Yeah. Were you worried about diehard fans of the original stage musical being very pernickety about the naturally understandable adjustments you've made?
I was, but I felt that, you know, because this is something that many people, you know, hold close to their hearts and are going to feel very protective over. But the fantastic thing was that when I was adapting it for the screen, you know, my screenplay team were Bill Nicholson, Claude-Michel Schoenberg, Alain Boublil, Herbie Kretzmer, as one of my producers, along with Eric Fellner, Cameron McIntosh. So I was reuniting the original team who'd created the show. When Claude Michel said, yes, we can cut that, we got excited about a change, I thought, well, you know, I can say to the fans, well, you know, the guy who created what you love, agrees or, you know, wants to do it. So it sort of gave it a sort of seal of approval. Mm-hmm. And the great thing about Claude Michel is he was very, he was remarkably sort of curious about the changes, and I think he saw it as a living organism. I mean, at some level, you know, if you've lived with it exactly the same for 27 years, you're probably yearning for someone to come and say, let's change it, you know, because it's just more interesting.